Hello everyone, myself Jyoti Mandala, working as assistant professor in GMR Institute of Technology. So today I'll be discussing about structures concept in C programming language. So structure is nothing but collection of one or more elements of different data types. So we all know what is an array. An array is nothing but a collection of one or more elements of similar data type, like all the elements should be of integer type, or all the elements of should be of float type, or all the elements of a character type. But if you want to store individual elements belong to different data types, then we need to go for a structure. So structure can be defined as collection of elements of heterogeneous data types. So here it is reflected in the slide, like a structure is a collection of one or more components which may be of different data types. Coming to other programming languages, structure is considered as a record and individual member is referred as a field in those programming languages. Now coming to the syntax for declaring a structure, whenever you want to declare one structure, it should be defined with a struct keyword. It is a keyword, struct is a keyword, and followed by a user defined tag name. And then we should have members list. Members list is nothing but for all the elements you want to include here of different data types, those should be declared in these two braces, between these two braces, and then followed by the variable list. So the next slide reflects the things what I have discussed here. It should have a struct keyword followed by a tag name, and then we should have a variable name. And the important thing here is always the variable list or a structure definition declaration should be end with a semicolon. That is the fourth step what I have written here, a terminating with a semicolon. Let us see one example here. I have considered a student structure. So struct student, a student may be considering of roll number, name, rank and branch. So roll number is of integer data type, name is of a character data type, so here name is of a string, and then rank is of integer data type and branch is also of a character data type. We can, if you want, you can include float, which may be giving which float of marks. So marks may be a floating data type. So here I have taken two students, st1 and st2. These two are structure variables. So this is one way, and the other way is, so here I have ended with a semicolon. Now the other way is declare one structure with the same variables, with the same elements, and ended with a semicolon. And the next step, I have written struct students st1 and st2. Any one of these two ways of declaring the structure is possible. Right, now we are coming to this point. Student 1, student 2, like then we can create like that. We can create n number of students, and each student is having the same copy of these things. So roll number, name, branch and rank is for student 1, and the same thing for student 2, roll number, name, rank and branch. Right, now this is the way of declaring a structure. Now coming for initializing the structure variables. Initializing is nothing but assigning values to variables. So similarly, if you want to initialize the structure variable elements, then it can be done in two ways. One is compile time and the other one is runtime. Compile time is nothing but at the time of compiling your program itself, the value should be available to your structure variables. Whereas coming to runtime, at the time of executing your program, the user will be giving the values to your elements. So first we'll see about what is compile time, later we'll go for the runtime. So compile time initialization. Compile time initialization is nothing but in the program itself, we need to assign the values. So I have taken the same example, struct student with the same elements, roll number, name, rank and branch. So while creating the structure variable itself using this assignment operator, I have given the values. So if you consider what is the first one, roll number. So I have given the roll number 1, 2, 3, 4, and then the name, so which is of string type, that's where I have put in the double quotations, and then the rank is 1 and the branch is of string type. Again, I have given computers with the double quotation. This is the one way of assigning the values at the compile time. The other way is we can declare the structure and with a semicolon, and then I have at the time of creating the structure variable using this statement, using assignment operator also, we can give the values. Observe the difference between these two. The declaration of the structure variable declaration and initialization are combined here, but whereas coming to the here, the declaration of structure is done and ended with a semicolon, and then I have declared a variable. Here the declaration of a structure variable and initialization of variables are combined here. Now, the other way is by using individual elements, we can assign the values by using an important operator, that is a dot operator. So I have initialized it, I have declared one structure, I have declared variable, structure variable, right? Ended with a semicolon. Now, individual elements of this structure can be assigned a values by using st1 dot operator, roll number, I have initialized the value. Similarly, st1 dot rank equal to 1, etc. Like other elements can also be assigned values by using the dot operator and the assignment operator. Now this is about compile time initialization. Now coming to runtime initialization. Runtime initialization means at the time of executing your program, you want to give the values. So we can use the scanf statement to initialize the values. So generally, how we are initializing the values for a variable at the runtime, same thing can be used here, scanf. We have used the format specifier. The first one is roll number, which is of integer type. I have used %d and ampersand st1 dot operator and roll number. Similarly, name. Name is of string type. Whenever we want to read the string variable, I have used the %s and we should not give ampersand. Got it? So this is the way of runtime initialization. So in this presentation, we have discussed what is a structure, what is the definition of a structure, what is the difference between structure and an array, how the structure can be declared, how variables can be declared, how elements can be initialized, compile time and runtime. Thank you.